Welcome back. Once again, this is Bruce Haber with the HUD Office of Lead Hazard Control and Healthy Homes. So we've completed our lead inspection, and now it's time to do the hazard assessment or the risk assessment of the same house. So once again, let's go back and meet our risk assessors. So we finished the lead-based paint inspection, and we're here with our certified risk assessors, Terrell and Bill, our husband and wife professionals, and we're here to look at the risk assessment process. So what's the next process? What's the purpose of the risk assessment? Why are we doing it?
The purpose of the risk assessment is to identify lead-based paint hazards throughout the home so that the owner can make whatever corrections are necessary. So we will be going back in, looking at those deteriorated paint areas that tested positive for lead-based paint, and noting the paint deterioration. We will also be collecting dust samples from those areas and sending those dust samples to an accredited laboratory so that we can determine if there's elevated levels of lead in the dust. We also noticed there are some bare soil areas here, and we will be collecting some soil samples and sending those to the accredited laboratory as well to see if there's elevated levels of lead in the soil.
And when we're all finished with this, what are we gonna know? What are we gonna be able to tell the owner?
Yes, when we're all finished, we're gonna generate a report for the owner with some recommendations on what the owner can do to ensure that the lead-based paint hazards are reduced or eliminated completely.
We're back in the bedroom with Terrell today to look at the risk assessment. We already completed the XRF paint testing here. And now, Terrell, what are we looking for and what are you going to be doing in this room?
In this room, I'm going to be doing a visual and collecting dust samples. One of the things that we do for the risk assessment is to look at paint conditions. We also look for dust and debris if there were any renovations that take place. And we see paint chips on the floor, we see excessive dust on the floor, we want to make note of that and use that as part of our dust sampling. But in a room like a bedroom, we're going to check the windowsills for teeth marks, we're going to check the doors for friction surfaces, definitely friction on that door because I can see the paint deterioration there. But we're also, as we go through, we're going to be looking for impact surfaces where damage could be occurring as well.
Do you do any more sampling in here?
In here, absolutely. We will be taking dust samples. We will take a dust sample from a windowsill. We'll also take a dust sample from the floor since that's an impact surface over there.
And I see that Bill is ready to do the sampling for dust testing, so I guess it's best that we move out of his way.
All right, Terrell, I'm doing window B, windowsill number 7. Yeah, Terrell, we have a lot of chipping paint right here.
We're back in the basement to do the hazard assessment. We've completed the risk assessment portions on the first floor and on the second floor. So we've done the kitchen and the living room, the dining room, the bedrooms, and the bathroom. We saw that upstairs. So now we're in the final area of the house, the basement. Down here, there's been a lot of renovation, and I can see that the walls and stuff are different than upstairs, and from testing, they were not lead-based paint. What are we going to do now for the risk assessment? What hazard are we testing for?
Well, we're going to sample down here. We're definitely going to sample the windowsills. Even though they're different than the windowsills upstairs, it's clear to me that there has been a lot of renovation going on down here, because renovation is still going on down here. So we want to take dust samples from the windowsill. Also, I would be interested in knowing what's in the dust under the stairs. Yes, because the stairs tested positive for lead-based paint, and I expect that because it's under stair storage, they didn't bother to clean it, but it could still be a hazard. So I would like to take a dust sample from there as well.
Very good. So with that in mind, let's get Bill and all his tape and measuring devices in here and get the dust testing done. Daryl, Bill, thank you for all your work today. It's been amazing watching you. You've been with the XRF in every room, tested the walls, the ceiling, the floor, the baseboard, doors, windows, window frames, door frames, radiators. You've done dust testing in each of the rooms. You've gone through and done a visual assessment for paint condition. You've done soil sampling outside, taken notes galore. With all this, now what do we do?
Well, the first thing I do is when I get to the office, I clean up the sketch that I made of the property. Then I prep the tubes and get the chain of custody prepared.
And while he's shipping that to the lab, I'm still downloading the information. I'm typing up my notes in order to generate the report. The report will contain where the lead-based paint is located, where the lead hazards are located. We also include options on ways to handle the lead hazards. We will add in the laboratory results and the sketch and share that information with the owner.
And so that concludes our risk assessment video for today. Previously, we had the lead inspection. And in the future, we will have a video on conducting a clearance examination and also a video of how to put together an inspection risk assessment report.